Hey, it don't come on Light TV. Now wait a minute, the program now. My Vision Time with Dr. Tobi Oyekanmi, the anchor and motivational and inspirational program. All the thing well now the expert don't buckle inside the program. Make we come the enjoy them from the presenter, your favorite anchor, Dr. Tobi Oyekanmi, as he gonna take us through spiritual counseling, dream interpretation, vision, and prophecy. Yes, so problem no be there again, no. As you go to watch live program on Light TV, no be only that one, oh. You go to see him from Instagram. Dr. Tobi Oyekanmi, just type and bang. You go see him there, oh. For YouTube, unko. For Light TV, you go watch him live for YouTube. Hey, now for Light FM Fire page, you now go to see him for Facebook, oh. Oh, yeah. Make una join us live on Light TV at YouTube, oh. To listen to the program we would only expect. As Dr. Tobi Oyekanmi go to drive all this time around, we go take him, enjoy him, and remain.
Ah, Olorun Oba lo se sibe bo se ri ni atorun wa ni eleyi yato fun awon eyi ti won se ni Nigeria ti won se America tabi ti won se ni London we eye ka wa si ibi ta nlo mo ki awon eyan temi kakakiri gbogbo Nigeria awon eyan temi kakakiri gbogbo agbaye awon eyan temi kakakiri gbogbo Africa gbogbo Australia awon anglophone countries francophone countries awon Mali Benenoa eni koro olawo ni jari mu ti won pe ni koro koro ni ko si wa leje e sami be se n gbo mi egbe ma wo wa kakakiri gbogbo agbaye patapata lati ni o to n waye to n dese ti gbo yin te n riwo bi iran nilu Ibadan mo ro n folo alenu bi age loruko temi omo to lenu bi kiwi ani njo kan ni mo ba lo se ko mo lo shemsi ladugo kan si won pe ni alagbado emi o mo yi pa alagbado ni won pe se mo pe aso mo eru wa omo yen omo agbado se mo pa agbado yen gan la wa n pe won ba gba beku ta wole tarata lo ba di adugo ti won pe ni ifo bi mo se de fo mo wo mo olu e re mo ba lo bi mo se de bi ti ma ti so kale mo so fe ni e wi pe oni yen gan ni ti so oni yen gan ni ti so oni yen gan ni ti so ẹgbọn tó kọ lásòhun mo rò pa mo lu òkè ni yín kò sóri yẹn ń bí o alágbàdo ni mo lò ní làákàyè ṣó o mọ wípé àgbàdo ló ń jẹ yẹn gan ni ọlọrun àgbàdo ló ń jẹ yẹn gan gbogbo ẹyin tèmi ẹ bá ti ń lọ síbì kan ẹyin náà máa ṣe bó ṣe yẹ kẹ ṣe ẹ sọrọ bó ṣe yẹ kẹ sọrọ and then ẹ má gbàgbé èdè ìlú yín o ọmọ ìlú wà lèmi agbọrọgún lèmi jẹ agbọrọgún alẹ sì wọdù ọmọ àṣepalẹ agbọrẹ pàlọwọ ojo gùnkè ogun dárúkè rúdò sílé àkọ gítà fi góòlù àrẹmú elégbèjì ọbẹ gbogbo rẹ níbi kùnrin akùnrin bíi ẹni ṣájá ọba níkà lágbègbè ọmọ ọba ti kọlá wọdẹ àríkù ti orí ẹjẹgùn bíi àrọnì gbogbo ẹgbáyé ẹ máa wo Light TV káàkiri gbogbo àgbáyé.
Glory be to the Lord, our God Almighty. I thank God for today, for my life, for your life. I really exalt His name for what He has done for you and I. This time is a terrible time around the world, but despite that, the powerful hands of God are still upon our life to protect us from all evil and to guide us and to lead us through. And I pray more that the love of God upon us, His power, will not forsake us. Father will see us through and it will make a way for us. And anything that you lay your hands on over there shall prosper in the name of Jesus. Amen. This is my vision time. I remain my name, Dr. Tobi Oyekanmi. So this segment, I want to give little advice to all our viewers out there. Well, what do I want to advise you on this moment? It is just one thing. And I want to advise not everybody, but there are few people all around the world that are borrowing money for party. You hear that? Few people around the world at this time borrowing money for party. Well, it's good to borrow money, it's good to party, it's good to, you know, in any form of party, be it wedding, birthday, naming ceremony, etc., etc. But I think this time is not a time for party. Even if we must party around this time, I think it has to be something that is important and necessary. Something that a party that you and I know that we can do without it. A party that you and I know that it is essential, that is crucial, that is important. We can do wedding, burial, and anything we want to do. We can party, but we just have to apply wisdom of God to whatever we want to do. And even if we must party around this time, I don't think you and I need to borrow money. If you need to borrow money at this time, I think you need to borrow money to take care of your family, to feed your family, and, you know, necessary things, important things, emergency matters. But not to borrow money or party just to feed yourself, to drink. Everywhere is locked down now. So I wonder why some people still sneak. Yes, I will use that word, sneak, to party. We are not allowed to go to church, to go to mosque, limited time to spend out there. But some people still find their time to borrow money and party. Hello? Do you think you need that around this time, even though if you need it, do you think you need to spend it on party, to drink and to eat, just like that, for one day or 2 days? And all the money spent will just go like that. You need money that you will borrow at this time to establish, to create. Creativity is important at this time around the world, because we just need to move on. We need to succeed. We need to be alive for ourselves, for your husband, for your wife, for your children. We need to be alive. We need to take care of ourselves, to protect ourselves from all this pandemic around the world. We need to apply wisdom. My little advice now is for you, please and please and please. Mo fi oruko Olorun be yin. Ibi gbogbo te tin wo mi, te tin gbo mi. Apply wisdom. If you must borrow money for something that is sensible, for something that is crucial, for something that is important, for creativity that can be useful for you now and after this time of trials all around the world. I pray that the powerful hand of God will be with you and you will never lack anything good in the name of Jesus. Eyawo lori nkan to da. Ema yawo lori anodanu. God will be with you.
Mora nungba ire wole wa mo gba leta kan more si ayo moro ke mo dele ajura mi ba o ti du mo faramo ajinda yo. What you gonna do?
I'm gonna
call it's over, okay. Life is beautiful, it's okay. Jesus, look already. I am here. No more trouble, no more sorrow. I don't go beg, I no go borrow. Jesus, no korede, korede, korede. Jesus, no korede, korede, a korede ni Jesus. Jesus, no korede. Ire ayo shalom jatemiyo. Jesus, no korede, korede, korede. Jesus, no korede. Morire ba, mo korede le. La reality, mo testify and glorify you, mama. Mo ajijo ope again again, be a last age. Once again I'm gonna do, I'm gonna call it over. Okay, life is beautiful, it's okay. Jesus lo korede, I am ide, I am ide. Oh, no my trouble, no my sorrow.
Hello viewers, I'm back. Yes, I'm back. Well, I want to share the word of God with you out there. I want to share the word of God with you. My sermon for a few minutes, I call it Faithful and Wise Servant. Faithful and Wise Servant. Well, are you a faithful servant and a wise servant? You know, Jesus is looking for a wise and a faithful servant. Will you find a time to worship the Lord? Will you find a time, you know, to concentrate on what the Lord is saying to you and to the world right now? Are you a praying type? Are you the type of Christian that is expecting the coming back of Jesus Christ? Does this time even minister to you or even signifies anything into your heart? Does this time really, really preach to you? Apart from reading the Bible, apart from listening to your pastors, to your reverend and prophets and prophetess out there, does this time, the time of this COVID-19, does it even minister to you? To calm you down, to caution you, to advise you? You know, time tells a lot in life. Jesus Christ is looking for the obedient servants. Jesus Christ is looking for faithful servants. Jesus Christ is looking for the wise one at this time. Are you wise? Are you a faithful one? Do you obey the commandment? What do you even think that is going on now around the world? Do you see it as a nature problem? Do you see it as God's anger? Do you see it as a mistake of scientists? Do you see it as a sin of you and I? Do you see it as a sign of coming back of Jesus Christ? Do you see it as a repetition of what normally happens every 100 years? How do you see this time? But I'm telling you that Jesus Christ is actually looking for the faithful and the wise one. If we go to the book of life, Luke chapter 12, verse 42. Luke chapter 12, verse 42. hear that? What I'm trying to say? In a short word, our Lord Jesus Christ, we've been hearing this for over many years. We've been hearing this, even while I was young, we've been hearing that the Lord Jesus Christ is coming back and we never see him. So do you still want to believe that, as they normally say, that Lord Jesus Christ is coming back, he will not come? This sign around the world, we can't say the sign around the world now is the dying minute sign for our Lord Jesus Christ to come. Truly is the sign of the end time. Is the sign of the end time. But I want to tell you that anytime you and I die, that is your own end time. That is the time your own Jesus Christ come. If you and I actually waiting for the end time, Jesus Christ is not coming yet, the rapture is not yet, well, we are right. But I want you to remember that you can die anytime. I can die anytime. Anytime I die, anytime you die, your Jesus come. My Jesus come. So are you ready? If you die today, any minute after now, are you ready if you die? Jesus Christ is looking for the wise one and the faithful one. Be wise. Be wise. You need to be wise. And how you must prepare yourself to be wise in front of your Creator is to daily search the scripture and prepare for his coming back. Not really his coming back, but he is coming back into your own life. Because anytime you die, it means that Jesus Christ has come into your life to arrest your soul, to take your soul away for keep, for the judgment. So don't join the multitude that believes and count on, the end time. Well, we believe in the end time, but Jesus cannot come now. He's not ready. All the signs that hasn't been fulfilled. We haven't seen all the signs yet. Good. But remember that you can die anytime. And immediately you die, forget it. No record can continue to count after your death. Everything will be, all the book will be closed. All your book, everything that you've done on earth shall be closed. And keep for the judgment. Will you now, after death, do good, correct your mistakes, or try to rap God? You can't rap God. You can't bribe God. Prepare for it. You and I need it. You get what I'm saying? You and I, we need it to prepare now, not tomorrow. Because immediately you and I die, Jesus has come. So don't join the multitude waiting for general end time, general rapture, general death, general mass death, general this, general that. Prepare for your own time. Prepare for your own end time. Prepare for your own grave. Jesus is looking for the wise and the faithful one. The powerful hands of God will be upon you. Jesus, Oluwawa. Amen. We shall fight there forever.
problem. Cause when Jah say yes, it's always yes.
It's always yes.
It's ever faithful and ever sure.
Hello viewers, you are back to another segment of this program, My Vision Time. Well, this segment we will treat just two things. The vision that God has revealed to me, and then interpretation of a dream. Well, as the Lord said to me that all pastors, all leaders of the churches, all pastors and leaders of the churches, we need to be more prayerful at this time and to be more careful and try to get in touch, carry your member along, pray along with them, counsel them, minister to them. Even though if we cannot meet together in fellowship, always find time through social media to get in touch with your people. Because the devil doesn't want some ministry to come back alive. After this catastrophic time, after this pandemic issue, when things come back to normal, some churches will be filled to stand on their feet again. Some ministry won't be able to meet up again. So for you, as a pastor, as a shepherd, as a founder, as a GO, and etc., you need to sit tight, be prayerful, carry your members along. Don't run around chasing money, forcing your members over tithes and all that kind of, well, let me leave that. Just concentrate on gaining their soul and trying to use your spiritual staff, you know, to guide them and to bring them back under the fold of Christ. Because some ministries won't be able to come back to the right feet after this pandemic. The Spirit of the Lord will be with you all. Amen. Well, the dream interpretation for today, if you dream and you see yourself eating a fruit, a ripe one, whichever kind of fruit, but a ripe fruit, a ripe one. It actually means that some of your labor, all that you have suffered for, all your prayers, all your efforts, the time that you are sowing a seed, then you are about to reap it. You are about to be happy. You are about to enjoy one or two things. You're about to praise the name of the Lord. You're about to have a breakthrough. You're about to achieve something important. If you see yourself eating a ripe fruit. Any kind of fruit, I mean. Any kind of fruit, but a ripe one. Simply means, like I said, that you're about to enjoy something tangible, something good, especially your labor, your effort in the past, the seed that you have sowed, you're about to reap it. So all you just need is to continue praying that what the Lord is about to do must come to pass, that devil mustn't snatch your joy away from you. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. So that is that for today. I will see you next week. You will see me next week and you hear from me next week. Don't forget, this is my different time. My different time. I remember my name, Dr. Toby. So you call me. The Spirit of the Lord will be with you. Whatever you don't want anybody to do with you, don't do it for others. But what you want people to do for you, you can practice it with your neighbor. God will be with you. Bye for now. Bye. Oh, ni lowo lowo iranlowo nigba to wa ti gba ti owo oro re.